So some very interesting news just dropped that kind of came out of left field. Not expecting this in the slightest, but it has been reported that Chris Rock, yes, that Chris Rock, came up with an idea to reinvigorate the Saw franchise. He took it to the people over at Lionsgate. They loved it, and now they are going to start working on it. This film will be written by the guys who wrote Jigsaw from his original concept. They are bringing back the director of Saw 2, 3, and 4, Darren Lynn Bousman. Bousman? I say this every time. I don't know how to say the guy's name. I'm gonna look it up one of these days. It's exciting. I mean, I have been a big fan of the Saw franchise since it came out. I mean, I even got dressed for the occasion. And I've enjoyed every entry in the series. I did a spoiler discussion on every single one of them, so if you want to know my thoughts on them, you can go there and check them out. But I am a big fan. I know that this is one of the most, like, this is one of those franchises that people love to hate. You know, it gets tons and tons and tons of hate. I personally disagree heavily with that, and they still make tons of money, so somebody likes them, me included. Chris Rock, okay. So I looked through Chris Rock's career after I saw this, being like, has he had any involvement in anything horror of any sort? No, not that I saw anywhere on his producer's credits, his acting credits, anything. No acting in horror in the slightest, which doesn't mean anything. I mean, whether or not you like the quality of these things, you had Jordan Peele break into horror with Get Out and most recently Us. And Danny McBride, of all freaking people, writing the screenplay for Halloween, H4O. I don't know what to call it. I hate always Halloween as the dumbest title. But yeah, wow, this is I just the fact that it was announced, I'm fine. Hell yeah, give me another Saw. I've enjoyed all of them. I have been calling for a reimagination of the franchise. I don't want a reboot. I don't want to get away from the storyline that we have. I just want to see new characters and getting away from Jigsaw. I think that John Kramer needs to be inspiration, sure, but they don't need to just keep coming up with reasons to put Tobin Bell in these movies. They really just don't. I know that they think their franchise hinges on him being a part of these and they have to sneak him into every movie, even if it's just at a book signing for 20 seconds. It's just not necessary. I mean, you could have his voice on tapes. You could have them watching old videos of his that were in the other films, like some guy works got a hold of all of his tapes that were in police lockup or whatnot, or there's like this whole internet following of it, and kind of like what they did with the character in Jigsaw. What was her name? It was like an old time name, like. Oh, I can't remember what the hell her Eleanor, right? Yeah, Eleanor. I like that idea. I like that idea of someone kind of following up his work as not a copycat, but somebody who is heavily inspired by his work and just completely getting away. You could make a whole fucking new trilogy out of this. Of course, I would love to see who those two men behind the masks were. With Dr. Gordon at the end of the final chapter, here we are, two films later. But that's typical with horror, as what did we just get announced? Freaking another final movie. I had to laugh out loud when I saw it. I was like, really? Another franchise that's putting final in the title? Oh, the final Purge. Come on. There's a season two of the Purge coming out this year, so the final. It's always the final. Anyway. This is, yeah, I mean, give me a good film. I don't really give a shit who writes it, right? I mean, that shouldn't really matter. I find it odd how people will be like, well, him? I mean, what credibility does he have in horror? Nobody has any credibility in horror until they make a horror movie. I mean, I don't want to discredit Chris Rock because I don't know the man. Maybe he did come up with an amazing thing. And even non-horror lovers, he says he's a big fan of the franchise. And I mean, I don't have any reason to doubt him. He maybe loves the shit out of it, and he did come up with a brilliant idea. Anybody could. And he just so happened to have a name and the star power and the money to put his money where his mouth is. And he went and he pitched it, and it worked, and good for him. I hope that his imagination is vast, and he comes up with something really cool to reinvigorate this. And I'm really looking forward to seeing if this actually comes to fruition. It looks like they're really going ahead with it. I mean, I've seen various sites reporting this all over the place. Darren Lynn Bousman is coming back to direct, so they've already signed him on, or he's already agreed to it. They've already got writers, they've already got Lionsgate pushing the thing, so I don't feel like this is some rumor mill bullshit. This is legit. This is gonna more than likely happen, and it's happening next year, 2020. So, hell yeah, man, bring it on. Yes. I mean, I'm not gonna knock his credibility because I don't know what it is. Maybe he did come up with something, but it's just the fact that it's Chris Rock that it's like, huh? But as I said, Jordan Peele, Danny McBride, I guess comedians are coming out of the woodwork to work on horror. I mean, I didn't really care. I liked Halloween. Fine, you can watch my full spoiler discussion on it. I went off on it for a long time, and I feel like I gave legitimate reasons. I didn't just go, it sucks, end, piece of shit, hate it, ruin the franchise. Nothing like that. Same thing with Jordan Peele. I'm not gonna get into that. You can look back on my stuff, but yeah, bring it on. I'm looking forward to it. What do you guys think? What about this news? Did it shock you as much as it shocked me? Are you hearing it from me for the first time? You probably are. I doubt you're looking for Saw reports, but I'm a big Saw franchise fan, so I got tagged in this shit the second it dropped from a friend of mine because he knew I'd be very interested, which I am. I do not want to see Tobin Bell have new material in this. He's getting way too old to play a character that died like over 10 years ago. He's looking old. We need to stop pushing him into the fucking story. But if it's done well, then I guess I won't complain. I liked what they did with Jigsaw and him, so I guess I'm being hypocritical here or contradictory. But whatever. We'll see what happens. Let me know what you guys think about this news. All right.